My name's David Youssef. I'm a station officer employed by the Metropolitan Fire Brigade based at the Ascot Vale Fire Station. I'm also the branch president of the United Firefighters Union. Melbourne's firefighters, together with their union, have produced this program in order to inform the community of the state government's proposals to privatise and downgrade Melbourne's Metropolitan Fire Brigade. Please take a few moments to view the program. It could save your life.
Melbourne's Metropolitan Fire Brigade is one of the most efficient fire services in the world, attending over 28,000 emergency calls annually, with a 5.5 minute average response time. The majority of Melbourne's fire trucks are staffed at very low levels, which are well below that of the Sydney Fire Brigade. There are now fewer than 1,480 firefighters protecting Melbourne, a reduction of well over 300 since 1990. The MFB is far more than just a fire service. It is a comprehensive community safety organisation. In recent years, it's taken on many new important roles. These include the provision of trench and tunnelling rescue, control of LP gas emergencies, high angle rescue, an urban search and rescue, and all firefighting and rescue at Essendon and Moorabbin airports, as well as the Port of Melbourne. All of this has been achieved with no increase in the MFB budget since 1992. Many people are also unaware that the MFB firefighters carry out all road accident rescue for people trapped at motor vehicle accidents. Obtaining and maintaining the skills necessary to deal with this wide range of incidents takes a great deal of time and dedication. Melbourne's firefighters are now also preparing to take on another major role, that is as Emergency Medical Service first responders. This role will see each and every fire station responding to medical incidents in conjunction with the ambulance service, in order to increase survival rates for persons suffering from cardiac illness or major trauma. The MFB estimates this could lead to a 200% increase in calls and have the potential to save many lives. This will make Melbourne's firefighters some of the busiest in the world, answering as many as 88,000 calls annually. This work, combined with the brigade's wide range of fire safety, fire prevention, and community education activities, makes the average firefighter a very busy person indeed. The idea of firefighters sitting around wasting time is just plain wrong. Firefighters are highly trained and dedicated specialists, eager to serve their community in its time of greatest need. The culture of the service is that firefighters will do whatever is necessary to get the job done, be that putting their own lives on the line or removing a tangled body from the scene of an horrific motor car accident. The Melbourne Coroner's Court recently heard evidence about the tragic Kew Cottages fire. This indicated just how far firefighters will go to save lives. They never give up. It's not in their nature. Tragically, 9 residents lost their lives in this fire, but many more were saved due to the heroic efforts of Melbourne's firefighters. CSIRO National Fire Statistics clearly show that a slow response to fires leads to substantially more property damage and loss of life. It's just common sense. If the brigade arrives and commences firefighting within 5 minutes, the fire will usually be confined to the room where it started. If it takes 10 minutes, the fire will have spread to other rooms. And in 15 minutes, your home will be engulfed, and your neighbour's home will be well on the way. This is why the MFB gets to 90% of all calls within 7.7 minutes. It makes no difference whether you live in Broadmeadows or Brighton. You can currently count on our rapid response. Unfortunately, the problem is now that the state government has released a report which recommends privatisation and a drastic downgrade of firefighting resources at your local MFB fire station. This is surprising considering that in 1993, the state government conducted an exhaustive and wide-ranging inquiry into the MFB and found that the organisation was efficient, served the community well, and that it should expand its role into new areas. There was certainly no mention of privatisation of the service. In fact, the MFB board president, Brian Parry, in his evidence to the inquiry, went to great lengths to detail the efficiency of the service, particularly in relation to it having the lowest manning levels of any service in Australia. He was clearly very happy with its performance. In fact, his confidence in the brigade was later confirmed when it was bestowed with a number of highly coveted awards for its exceptional service to the community. Even the Treasurer, Mr. Stockdale, has praised the sterling work of MFB firefighters during debates in Parliament. MFB Board President Parry is now advocating privatisation, supposedly to provide for a more cost-efficient service. Well, we think that if there's one thing that the community has learnt about privatisation, it's that the service is never the same, and that it inevitably costs the customer more. In the case of the MFB, the cost may be measured in lives, not dollars. There are substantial cost savings to be made in the emergency service area, and they can be achieved by the common sense amalgamation of the Metropolitan Fire Brigade and the Country Fire Authority. This single change would save the Victorian community tens of millions of dollars annually, whilst providing an improved service in the growth corridors of the state. By contrast, the MFB admits that its privatisation and downgrading changes, if implemented, will lead to an increase in the MFB's current 7.7-minute response times. Experts know that this change will result in increased property damage, loss of life, and suffering. The staffing situation at your nearest fire station is already critical. If these recommendations are accepted by government, they will put the community at great risk due to reduced firefighting, fire prevention, and community education services. Highly trained and respected firefighters will be made redundant to clear the way for a privatised fire brigade, employing staff on a casual basis. As has been well documented in the United States, it is impossible to provide the same service under these circumstances. The reality is that privatisation and downsizing will lead to there being fewer firefighters, having far less experience, fewer vehicles, resulting in much slower response times. Firefighters know too well that this is a recipe for disaster. Most people are unaware that the state government contributes only 12.5% of the MFB's budget, with the remainder coming from your insurance premium, fire levies, and local government contributions. Up until now, the state government has not considered that consultation with the community and local government has been necessary. So it's time that you had your say on the future of your service. Melbourne's MFB firefighters need your help to save the service that saves you. There is only so much that we can do. We need you to contact your local state members of parliament and tell them what you think about the government's proposals to privatise or downsize your MFB. Also make a written submission directly to the Metropolitan Fire Brigade's board, and take time to explain to your friends and relatives just what the government has in mind for your world-class fire service. If you want more information, visit your local MFB fire station. The firefighters would be very pleased to see you. Or contact the United Firefighters Union on 941 98811. And you can also visit our internet website.
This time, Melbourne's firefighters need your help. Let's work together to save the service that saves you. You'll never know when you may need us.
Oh, firefighters. When the community calls, they are there. Protecting property and saving lives. We all need